Welcome to a more functional version of Mercedes-Benz's new Actros GigaSpace. What I've had all these days is a single rear axle, so I'm just planning to change it. As you can see in the garage, and when I'm at it, I want to make it a little bit simpler too. So first things first, I'll pick up a mid-lift, probably mid-lift axle, so that I really like the fact that wheelbase doesn't get affected as much as probably a tag lift would. Okay, and looks like all my paint and everything else has come back to its default settings, but that's okay, we'll fix that soon. It's looking really good, but only thing I'm a little bit concerned about is the fact that the fuel tanks have really reduced in size. Yeah, from side it looks pretty good. And if you were to paint it up in the usual Globex colors, you can look at another video that I've made. Here I don't need to redo that entire thing because I've saved it as a preset. So at one click I can just finish that. Okay, next, let's look at a few other things that I want to change. I want to bring back the side skirts that went away when I your axles. It's there on both sides, that's good. Now, this particular Globex board also went away when I got the in-cabin accessories DLC. I'm not sure why that happened, but that went away and now I've got that back. The game seems to remember that it's Globex. I didn't have to type that out again, which is kind of weird. And then I've got another DLC for the wheels, so I'm gonna go ahead and go crazy with the wheels this time around. In Globex colors, of course. See, this is the advantage of saving it as a preset, you don't need to go and select the color each time. And the hubs and the covers. Lights. I don't use them most of the time and I just want a cleaner, simpler look in the front. So the entire bar and all the lights along with it are going. I'll probably get a few other things in place of that. I won't bother with any of these bars in the front. But what I'm going to change is basically chrome to the windows. I like that, very understated, because it's not completely chrome, it's just a portion. Everything else looks as fine as it can be. Okay, this is looking good. I think I can keep it like this. I think I'll just keep it with the runner tires. None of this. I don't even know what this error is. I'll just say no. Runners all around, front and rear. The advantage of having the white painted tires is when you have lifted the middle axle off the ground, it's very easy to identify whether that wheel is rotating or not. It looks better when you've got that wheel off the ground. And of course keep it white. We'll be changing the color of that runner. And yet another runner. Okay. Okay, this is looking like how I want it. Probably just go ahead and make those same changes that I made to the front wheel out here also. These are really weird nuts, but you know what, I'm just gonna go with them just for kicks and because I've got the DLC. Last axle. Alright, I'm nearing the end of what I wanted to do with this particular truck. I think it'll serve me well and I'll be able to lug heavier loads, which I was staying away from. I'll know on the next drive if I really like this setup. That's it for now. Thanks a lot. See you later.